Hello, so I'm going to quickly run through how to fix the deprecation warning with DDGS in LangChain. It's a deprecation warning which talks about the DuckDuckGo search run. And what you do is you get a DDG deprecated. You can see it here on the screen. And if you're fed up of getting that or it's compromising your results, what you need to do is this. So you've got these key value pairs. You've got body, title, and href. I'm going to pick out the body. So I'm using a list comprehension, and that's going to iterate over the generator. So instead of actually returning the results now, we use this. So from DuckDuckGo search, import DDGS, we'll create, in fact, I don't even need that. So results equals DDGS.text, Tesla stock price, and then we just iterate over the generator. So I'll just show you that. We get all of the text that we got before. Now, if you don't know what a generator is or you don't not in the habit of using them, let's just go down. I've asked ChatGPT, generators in Python offer memory efficient iteration by generating values on demand. They employ lazy evaluation, improving performance for large data sets even, and allow processing before the entire sequence is generated. You can see that was my question to it. Prior to that, I asked it for a 200 word response. And prior to that, it gave me the full response. So yeah, memory efficiency, lazy evaluation, improved performance, simplified code, and infinite sequences generators are particularly useful when working with potentially infinite sequences of data, such as streaming data or mathematical sequences. Since generators generate values on the fly, they can handle sequences that are too large to fit in memory or that are dynamically changing. Overall, generators perform a powerful, flexible way to iterate over data in memory efficient and performant manner, making them a valuable tool in Python programming even. So yeah, I'll put the link to the gist where I've just put the very basic code there for you. And yeah, good luck.